Exelev is at the top of his game as an Irish rugby seven star, but ever since he first picked up a ball, there has been one person on his team who has stood by him through thick and thin. Tonight, he has a simple message for her. He is on her team as well. Dancing the foxtrot, it's Jordan Conroy and Salome Chachua.
I'm dedicating this dance to my wonderful mammy, Jenny Conroy. Grew up in Germany, lived there for 10 years. It was an okay life. We had our, you know, our troubles. Being a child of domestic abuse wasn't easy, but she put her kids first and moved us back to Ireland towards family and made sure we were protected. Didn't really need much. We were rich in other ways, like. So this week we are dedicating the dance to you because you've amazing strength to, you know, kind of raise two kids by yourself. I just want you to know I'm really proud of you.
Okay, can I have that engraved into something? A piece of marble, please. I wouldn't be who I am if it wasn't for you and your sister. So I thank you too.
It's like, it's not every day you get to thank your mum on national TV.
I'm actually dying to see what he comes up with.
So, the dance is foxtrot.
Hey, this is the Valentine's, Mother's Day's, birthday and Christmas gift all in one.
Down. Foxtrot going okay. Jordan is very motivated this week.
I'm dancing for someone special to me, so yeah, obviously I want to make sure that dance is the best it can be.
Dancing the foxtrot, Jordan Conroy and Salome Chachua.
Jordan and Salome, everyone, well done.
Thank you.
Well done. You were very emotional in rehearsal. Well done for getting through that. A gorgeous tribute to the lady that is here every Sunday night, isn't she? The mammy, there she is. Well done. Let's go to Arthur.
Jordan, now, anyone who dedicates the dance to their mother gets my vote.
Thank you.
It was such a stripped-back performance from from last week, 360 turnout, you know, from fierce paso. But I have to say, I expect a little bit more. I know you.
Yeah.
You know, there was some stiffness going on. I just want to grab you and shake you, you know. And foxtrot, you have to be very light on your feet, you know. great dancers have great passion, and you have that passion. I know that. So I want to see that passion back next week.
I got you. Okay? I got you.
Okay, yeah. We'll go to Brian.
Well, we've been really complimentary with you over the last few weeks, but tonight I'm going to do something that I bet your mum has done a few times. I'm going to get the waggy finger out just a little bit, right? In places, as Arthur says, it was just a little bit wooden, maybe slightly out of sync with Salome. It just needed to be more fluid, more flowing, more finesse. That's what Foxtrot is. But where you were fantastic was across the shoulder line, and your spine was beautiful. So a lot of improvement, but given the pressure of Dedicated Dance Week, you did a very good job.
Okay, that's what we like to hear. You got the wagon finger, but not the wooden spoon. That's good.
The cutest moment for me was just before you started. You're standing there like that little boy, and your fingers are twitching. And I thought that was really gorgeous. The guys have said it. I'm not going to go over it again and that. So let's just look to the future. No one's going home, okay? Yeah. And just a few little notes for you. You know, stand up, get your own space. You did do a good. I wasn't sure if you were going to make that foxtrot tonight, but you did. You made it, and you had the heels and the toes, and they were there. It just wasn't quite fluid enough, and that's something that you can work on. Fluidity, spaces, coordination.
Thank you. All right.
Well done.
But your mammy, more than anyone, forget about us, Ten. She's the most proud in this room tonight.
Yeah.
Well
thank
done.
You.
Ten
you.
From the mammy. Your